Hello, this is Chapter 2, Section 3, Significant Figures in Calculations. In chemistry, we frequently need to use measured numbers to calculate other properties or quantities. Since the measurements themselves have some uncertainty, the answers we calculate with them must also have some uncertainty. When you put numbers into your calculator, however, it doesn't understand that it needs to limit the precision of the answer, and often it just gives you as many digits as it can display. It's up to you to understand how the precision of the measurements affects the precision of the answer. At times, this means you'll need to round an answer obtained from a digital calculator. Before we continue, let's review the rules for rounding numbers. Now, before you can round a number, you first need to figure out how many digits you want to keep. Later on, we'll see how to do that, but for now, we can assume we know how many digits to keep just so that we can practice. To round a number, you first count the number of digits you want to keep starting from the left. Then you look at the next digit after the last one you're keeping. If that digit is less than 5, you just drop all the digits you don't need. That's called rounding down. If that digit is 5 or greater, you increase the last digit you're keeping by 1 and then drop the rest. This is called rounding up. You can see some examples here in this chart. The first column has the numbers we need to round. In the second column, we're going to round them to 3 significant figures, and in the third column, we'll round to 2 significant figures. The first example is the number 8.4234. To round it to 3 significant figures, we keep the first 3 digits from the left, the 8, the 4, and the 2. Then we look at the next digit, and we see that it's a 3. Since that's less than 5, we can just drop it along with the rest of the digits, and we end up with 8.42. If we want to round it to only 2 digits, we just keep the 8 and the 4. And since the next digit is a 2, we again round down by dropping the remaining digits, leaving us with 8.4. The next example is 14.780. To round it to 3 significant figures, you keep the 1, the 4, and the 7, and look at the next digit, which is 8. Since that's greater than 5, you have to round up the 7 to get 14.8. To round to 2 significant figures, you keep the 1 and the 4, and look at the next digit, which is a 7. That's bigger than 5 again, so you have to round up to get to 15. The last example can be confusing, so pay close attention. The original number is 3,256. To round this to 3 digits, we keep the 3, the 2, and the 5. That's our 3 digits. The next digit here is a 6, which is greater than 5, so we have to round this 5 up to 6 before dropping this 6. However, if we just drop that 6 like we've been doing, we would come up with an answer of 326. Obviously, 326 is not very close to 3,256. The trick is that when we drop a digit to the left of the decimal point, we need to replace it with a 0 so that all the digits stay in their correct place value. The same thing happens when we round it to 2 digits. We keep the 3 and the 2, and look at the next digit, a 5. Since it's 5 or greater, we round the 2 up to 3, and then drop the 5 and the 6. But again, we know that 3,256 is nowhere close to 33, so we have to remember to replace the drop digits with zeros to get 3,300, or 3,300. Now try pausing the video and doing a couple of examples on your own before we look at the solutions. We want to round the number 3.1457 down to 3, and then 2 significant figures. For 3 significant figures, we keep 3 digits from the left, 3.14. Then we see that the first digit we're dropping is 5, so that tells us we need to round the 3.14 up to 3.15. For 2 significant figures, we keep the 3.1, and the next digit is a 4, which means we can round down by just dropping them and keeping 3.1. The rules for rounding may be hard to understand at first, but it might help to know where they come from. Take this example of 3.1457. When we round to three digits, we keep the 3.14, but the original number is really 3.14 plus a little bit. The rules for rounding just help us figure out whether that extra little bit makes the number closer to 3.15 than to 3.14. In this example, it does. 3.1457 is a little closer to 3.15 than it is to 3.14, so we round up. We can do the same thing for rounding to two digits. 3.1457 is just a little bit closer to 3.1 than it is to 3.2. Hopefully that helps you understand the process a little better, but if not, you can always stick to the rules. Now we get to the real reason for all this rounding. As I mentioned, when we use measured numbers in calculations, we often need to round the answer to the correct number of significant figures. In the next few slides, we're going to learn how to figure out how many digits the results of a calculation should have. The first rule is for multiplication and division. When you multiply or divide measured numbers, your answer should only have as many significant figures as the measurement with the fewest significant figures. In this example, 24.66 has 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures, but 0.35 has only 1, 2 significant figures. So the final answer must only have two significant figures. Remember that your calculator doesn't understand this, so it's up to you to take the number it gives you and round it to only two digits. In this case, the 3 here is less than 5, so you can round down by dropping the digits you don't need. We can use the same rule even with more than two measured numbers. In this case, the 21.5 has 3 significant figures, the 0.30 has 2 significant figures, and 1.88 has 3 significant figures. The fewest significant figures is 2 for this measurement, so the final answer will only have 2 significant figures. As long as the only operations involved are multiplication and division, you can use this rule. On some occasions, a calculator will actually show fewer digits than we know we need based on these rules. When that happens, we need to add significant zeros to the answer so that it has the correct precision. In this example, the two measured numbers happen to give a result that appears to be an integer. But based on the rule for significant figures, we know it should have two digits because 6.0 has two significant figures. So we have to add an extra zero to make the answer 3.0. This doesn't happen too often, but it's still useful to keep in mind for occasions when it comes up. Let's do another example. Here we have three measured numbers being multiplied or divided. Take a minute to figure it out before we look at the correct answer. In this example, the denominator here has the fewest significant figures with only two. So our answer should have only two significant figures as well. The calculator will display 8.52, which we then have to round down to 8.5. For addition and subtraction, however, the rule is different. When you add or subtract measured numbers, the answer will have the same number of decimal places as the measurement with the fewest decimal places. It sounds like the same rule, but this time we're only counting decimal places, not significant figures. This example should help clarify. Remember, when you add numbers together, you line up the decimals so that you keep the place values aligned. This helps you see that this first number has 3 decimal places, this one has 2 decimals, and this one has only 1 decimal place. Since the last one has the fewest decimal places, that's what determines the number of decimals in the answer. The calculator will say the answer is 174.102, but you need to round that to the tenths place to get 174.1. Notice that the number that has the fewest decimals was not the number with the fewest significant figures. The first number here has the fewest significant figures, but that's irrelevant when we're adding and subtracting. Here we can see another example with subtraction this time, and the same idea applies. This second number, 3.0, has only 1 decimal place, while the other number has 2. so our answer is limited to just one decimal. That means we have to round the 62.09 to the tenths place, and we get 62.1. Take a minute to try one more example before we move on. Here we need to add two masses, 82.409 milligrams plus 22.0 milligrams. Hopefully you can quickly see which number limits the precision, so let's take a look at the answer. Since this second number has a precision only to the tenths place, our answer has to be rounded to the tenths place as well. So we get 104.4. Remember that we're rounding down because the next digit in the hundredths place is less than 5.